What is up, everybody? Welcome back. Today we are starting a new franchise mode, and we're going to be using a team that, you know, GM was recently fired, a lot of number one overall draft picks, and one of those draft picks turned into the best player in the league right now, and they are just not playing so well, and I'm sure you guys could all tell. I'm talking about Connor McDavid, and we are going to be trying to get the Edmonton Oilers back to a winning franchise because they have been so bad. Like, it's unreal. Trading away Taylor Hall, it's terrible. So I'm just going to make sure. So, obviously, franchise mode. I had a lot of views on the Ranger one. Kind of blew up a little bit. But the Ranger one is going to... I am done with it. You know, I haven't been on it in a while. I kind of want to get a fresh start. And we won two cups, so I think it was a successful franchise. And we did have a sick team, and obviously paying Matthew Tkachuk $10 million is pretty. Yeah, I had some good times. Of course, they didn't really want to re-sign for some reason, because I think we got bounced, like Sergachev and Tkachuk didn't want to re-sign because we got like bounced in the first round when we were like President's Trophy, and I completely overpaid them. I'm surprised I hung on to all of them, but. You know, I just say I resigned from that, and they are basically pulled a Steve Yzerman, you know. So we're starting the Edmonton Oilers, you know, Shirelli's out. Rich Homie Kloon's in. So I'm going to just start off. I did actually create a few more prospects. I thought about if there's anybody on the Oilers I maybe had to create, but I was thinking about creating Kale McCarr, but I didn't, so if you guys are thinking about that. First off, I actually did give Jesperi Kotkaniemi. He was medium elite in the beginning of the year, and they put him down the low elite, but the way he's been playing, he's definitely worth medium elite, so I gave him that medium elite potential. And obviously, for the Fog of War, I did put on the potential, and you could see their player type because I like the. Those are two things I like to see. So that I made a little change at Kotkaniemi. Obviously, all the Ranger guys. I'm just trying to think of. For the New York Islanders, I created Oliver Wahlstrom. Made him like I think I made him 69 overall. With high top six potential. For the Rangers, I did give Vitali Kratsov medium elite, just because he's 74 overall, I'm pretty sure. Just because he's playing, he's been playing well, and he's been rated the number one prospect. That isn't signed, so something like that. For Ottawa, I did create Josh Norris. Gave him, I think he's a 75 overall. Made him what, a sniper, a playmaker? I made him a sniper with medium, high top six. So they actually have it with Shabbat, Tkachuk, you know, so they're looking pretty good. I think that is it. I don't think I created anyone else. Of course, we have Quinn Hughes. Yeah, so we created Josh Norris and Oliver Wahlstrom. Of course, two stars of the... We could have probably created Tyler Madden for Vancouver. But we're all good with that. So coming to the Edmonton Oilers, we'll look at our team real quick. We'll probably sim half the season. Probably put a few people on the trade block. So here's the team, of course, with Connor McDavid and Leon Draisaitl, two guys who will probably hang on. But the question is, Jesse Puljujarvi. Of course, in real life, he just hasn't found his game, really, with the Edmonton Oilers. But in NHL with medium elite potential, he'll definitely be good. But should we make this kind of realistic and try to shop him and get something big for him? I would like to hang on to him. I think a guy like Nugent Hopkins, we might have to move on from with a medium top 6, 85 overall. Making $6 million, I mean, he's good, but I don't know. We might have to move on from him. And, of course, one of the greatest contracts in the NHL. Milan Lucic. 30 years old. 5 more years on a $6 million salary. I don't know if we'll be able to move this. We might have to hold on to him. But we'll throw him on the trade block, see if someone will request. So let's head to the trade block a little bit. Whoops. Obviously, I don't know where they are approached. I don't know how good we'll be. Obviously, the goalie situation isn't the best either. So let's take a look at it. So we'll put Puljujarvi on the trade block. Just see if, because he's got so much value. We'll put Nuge. And we will put... Should we put... We'll just put Lucic, I guess. See if we can get something, but probably nothing. So let's take a look at our lines and our team. See what we're looking like. So we have, obviously, Nugent. Obviously, they've been riding with Draisaitl at the left wing, Connor McDavid. And right now it's Tyratty. I'm actually going to bump just Puljujarvi up. Nugent Hopkins, Reeder. Yeah, and then Spooner, who I think's on waivers. But he's actually pretty good in this game. So, obviously, the team... I'm going to bump Spooner up. And who's got better face-offs? 70 and 79. Okay, so Brozniak will be in our defense with Klefbom, Larson, Karen Nurse, Benning, Petrovic, Yamamoto. Nice prospect. Hopefully he could develop into something. And our goalie's Mikko Koskinen, 6'7", 30 years old. Who I think they just signed him. Cirelli signed him to what? 1 year? 3 years and $4.5 million. And Cam Talbot just been dropping off. One more year on $4 million. He's just... Now he has our backup. So goalies is something we're going to have to... We're going to have to get maybe in the draft or so. So I'm just going to take a look at our prospect pool. Obviously, I think Puljujarvi is one of our top... Yeah, Evan Bouchard obviously was just drafted. I think he will be a decent piece for the future. Yamamoto, hopefully he'll develop. We have Caleb Jones at medium top six. So he's 76 overall, so he can maybe play this year. We have Ryan McLeod, low top six though. Another medium top six. Medium top. So we have a lot of medium top six defensemen. Medium top four. So we have a pretty good defensive prospects. Offensive, it's alright, I guess. A bunch of low top Tyler Benson here. So, might as well. I'm just going to scroll through the trade block here for each team. Broussard, Hoffman, Yandel, Alder, first, third, Matt Martin, they want to get rid of. Alright, so it seems like a lot of the contending teams just want to trade their first round pick, which can be good if we could. I don't even know. And we don't really have much cap. But. So let's just see. Let's just get through preseason. I can't wait. Oh, I can't wait to, like, think of. Maybe we have to pair someone with, like, Dave. That's going to be crazy. I mean, obviously in NHL, you don't know. We actually might be good this year. Right after this, we'll go to the scouting. We'll see what we could do. Obviously, we could try to exchange. Yeah, we'll assign the scouts. And got a lot of nice A-pluses in the regions. Look at prospects. Might as well just get them started on skaters. Might as well get them going. I actually really didn't really look at much prospects. I didn't really do much scouting with the Ranger franchise. So I'm going to try to get more involved into this. Just kind of get them going. And we'll just leave it at that. I don't know why I'm in November. So our first game is against New Jersey Devils. Maybe I'll play the third period. You know what? No, I'm actually going to... I would like to just simulate maybe the first month. See if we get any trades. Matt Benning was injured. I'm just going to do assistant coach. Because I'm just trying to get through the first... And I fucking hate these injuries. I might have to find a slider, try to turn them down. I think in the Ranger one, I turn them off. I just like it. No injuries at all. We start off 1-2. Ty Ratty. I'm just going to do best lines. Win 4-1 against... Let's take a look at the draft class. Obviously, Jack Hughes, at this point, is number one overall. I did put him on the Wheat Kings, I think. I don't know why. I just picked a random team. Kaku and Bowen Bryan could be... Obviously, if we need a defenseman, you know, we could try to trade up and get them. There's also a defensive defenseman here. Not too much scouting yet. Like I said, I want to try to get through the first month, see if we get any trade offers. And, maybe take a closer look at our team, of course, see how we're doing. We're 5-3 so far, so not that bad. We beat Jets, Boston, and fucking Predators. Predators again, we beat them in a shootout, lose the Blackhawks. Obviously, I don't really know what our approach is this year. I guess if we're going to make the playoffs, we might as well try to improve the roster. But so far, no trades. We're 9-6. Beat Tampa. And we're 10-6 in the first month. Or first. With Ryan Nugent-Hopkins leading the way with 14 points. Obviously, we can maybe look to trade Puljujärvi for someone, I guess, someone else. Maybe a little more developed, like a Clayton Keller. That would be pretty fun to have Keller on this team. Obviously, I think we'll throw more in. We'll send a scout out to scout Keller. Just get his whole entire... that's what I'm going to think I'm going to do with Puljujärvi. I want to try to get someone. I think, yeah, so Coyotes are Pacific Division. Oops. So I want to try... I might use Puljujärvi and try to ship him out and try to get a more developed young Wayne to pair up with McDavid. So I don't know what the fuck I'm doing. Where the hell are the scouts? Here we go. Sound scout. No, we're not the... Damn it. Not the draft class. Just because in real life, Puljujärvi just isn't fitting with the Oilers, so we'll make it a little realistic here. Obviously, I don't think Coyotes would trade Clayton Keller, but whatever. We'll make it a little interesting. What were they? Pacific? AHL Pacific. I didn't know that was a fucking thing. NHL Pacific. Here we go, my guy. What is it? Scout a group of players, I think. Oh, no. It's specific players. Whoops. It's fucking overall D. Jesus fuck. We need Arizona. Maybe we'll scout a few extra too. Phone is ringing in there. So Clayton Keller was basically almost scouted all the way. I want complete for Keller. Let's see if there's anyone else. Maybe we could scout. We'll scout. Oh, Galchenyuk, I think, is fully scouted. And, Nick Schmaltz is scouted too. Who else is not really scouted? Nick Merkley. And we'll scout Lawson Crouse too. He could be a nice young piece for us. So we'll send the scout out to scout them. Obviously, we're going to have to go through. I might go through a few teams. We'll keep this going. Keep this sim going a little bit. We'll simulate to The 8th of December. We're already in November? Oh, fuck. Let's keep it rolling. Honestly, I haven't really edited the team. 10-6-2, not bad. I thought we were going to Battle of Alberta and we win. 11-6-2. 12-6-2. Alright, overtime loss. Anaheim. Another shootout loss. At least we're getting these points. At least we're playing, I think, better. Obviously, I mean, if we have the best player in the league. But I think our goalie situation might have to be improved to make a deep playoff run. Obviously, maybe we could try to, if Bobrovsky becomes a free agent, he could be a top he could be a top free agent for us. And that would be pretty sick to have Bobrovsky as our goaltender. But, of course, we're going to have to free up that cap. We can maybe even get Panarin too, but they usually, I think one or both of them usually sign. I've seen Panarin maybe more than Bobrovsky, but a lot of times I don't even check. Connor McDavid leading the way with 26 points, and we are second in our division with a 16-8-5 record. Not bad. We might have to. Let me see the free agents. What do we got free agents? Anyone good? Ryan Malone. What a guy. Is there any way to, like, scout fucking these guys? I don't think so, but there's really nobody here. I obviously think Rick Nash is somewhere by now. Obviously, I think the lines aren't working, so I meant to go to the draft, but I think it switched over lines. I thought I was going to go lines, but we're in the trade. So Clayton Keller is fully developed at an 84 rating. How many more years does he have left on that? He's got 2 more years left on his entry-level deal. Obviously, he's a playmaker, and I think maybe we should try to look for a sniper to pair with McDavid, even though McDavid's everything, but I think McDavid is a playmaker, right? Yeah, but McDavid, no. Oh, man, he's crazy. I'm kind of going to weigh my options here. Might as well go through and see what kind of... I mean, Pastrnak would be insane. Darling's injured. Calgary Gaudreau would be crazy, but I'm valuing way too much. Aho is high top 6. Ratanen would be crazy. Dubois, there's Panarin. Can maybe make a run at Panarin. Zadina is injured. You know what? I might just try to go get Keller. Put him on a... I'll try. I don't know. Obviously, we're playing well. So, Clayton Keller, 84 overall. We'll send back... They don't really want Puljujärvi. And Puljujärvi, I think, is now an 80 overall. He's playing well. And he's considered a sniper. So, obviously, the value... We're a little bit far off. Maybe we could throw in like a second or third round pick, which we have a we'll try throwing in this Islander third round pick too. And they rejected. Maybe we'll try a second round pick and former fourth overall Jesse Puljujärvi. Table's too far off. Maybe we'll try our second and fourth round picks. Table's too far off. Maybe second round this year and third round next year. Oh, we're going to swing it just a touch. So we'll be trading Jesse Puljujärvi. 2019 second, 2020 third, and hopefully this late round pick for Clayton Keller, who is already an 84 overall and will be way better. And pairing up with McDavid might be lethal. And they're probably going to get a little greedy. Obviously, I don't know if this trade will go down in real life. Maybe. Oh, come on. What do they want, a fourth? Jesus Christmas. All right, third and fourth of 2020 and 19 and Puljujärvi. And there it goes. We have made a huge trade. I'm just going to do best roster for now, and I'll go back and edit the lines and whatnot. So we made a huge trade. Obviously traded away a second, third, and a fourth. But we still go out and make a huge trade for fucking Clayton Keller. Should we stick Nugent Hopkins? I mean, our first line is McDavid, Draisaitl, and Clayton Keller. I think we'll stick Keller on that left wing. Oh, man, that first line is pretty lethal. I think Clayton Keller and McDavid is going to be pretty fun to have. But obviously, we added a bigger piece than what's his face, Puljujarvi. So I'm just gonna see if we could try to make some trades to maybe free up some cap, because we don't have any. Maybe let's see what we got. 8 million. Of course, Lucic. Sakara's making 5 million. Ooh, we might have to, and he's got pretty good value, so we could probably get rid of that contract. Chris Russell making 4 million. Jesus fuck. Alright, so we're gonna look to trade Sakara. I don't know if we should trade him now. I think we could actually probably get a second round pick for him. Maybe go to a team. The Bruins want him. Just to free up some cap. Or we can maybe even get their first round pick. If we maybe throw in a little more. We'll try the... I don't think that we... I think they have a little more value, but we'll see. No. That would be pretty crazy if we get a first round pick for him, but maybe we'll try to get a second and a third for Andre Sakara. Right, we'll try to go back to Calgary. I don't even think I had a second. Fuck. I only have fucking two picks. You gotta be kidding me. Let's look for a team. Okay, maybe the Minnesota Wild. So second, third, and fifth for Andre Sakara. Who's 32 years old, exact top four with a $5.5 million. Obviously, we can maybe bring up Caleb Jones. Or I think we have Brandon Manning. So we have defensemen we could throw in there. They don't really... Oh, they don't want to take the salary on. What if we take away the fifth? Damn, that's a good... They would accept that shit. Damn, it's fucking... Look at the Penguins, 12, 11, 4... Do they want extra help? We'll trade second round pick. Next year's salary. Bastards. Washington will be over. Okay, maybe the Jets. They want to get rid of Niku. Medium top four potential. 22 years of age. Maybe we could try to get him. Straight up for Sakara. We trade away. Okay, so we're going to be trading away, and they, I mean, hopefully they'll take it, you know, hopefully they're not trying to, I mean, let me just see, because Niku we could probably play, but he'll just add to our prospect pool. We'll have Klefbom, Nurse, Larson, then we'll have Petrovic, Benning, and then Kate. Okay, so yeah, we can trade away Sakara right now. We'll throw in like a 7th or a 5th round pick or something, maybe next year's 6th. Oh, come on. Damn, I thought they were going to take that. Sammy Niku was a medium top four prospect. They're trying to get rid of it, but they don't want it. Maybe if we retain some salary, maybe retain like 1.5. Because I wouldn't mind, because Niku, another medium top four prospect for him, I would do that any day of the week. Our penny for injury, not comfortable taking it. Ugh, God damn it. What if I retain 2 million? At least get 3 million off. I don't really know if I want to. God damn it. Alright, let's just try to retain half his salary. Okay, so we retained half of Sakara's $5.5 million. And we trade also, so let me just see. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So Niku, just because I want him playing, we'll probably throw him in the minors. So we get a medium top four defenseman. So an extra prospect for an aging veteran, of course. We have Klefbom Larsen. I think we need like an offensive defenseman here. We have a lot of big guys. Chris Russell's playing fucking first line. Oh my God. So let's just do best lines. We get Nico in there with Caleb Jones. And then offense. Oh my God, our fucking team sucks. Oh wait, is fucking Yamamoto still scratched? You might as well fucking send him down. Have him play. Totally forgot about him. Yeah, might as well. So come back to. So I actually like that trade. Obviously, we couldn't get rid of the whole 5 million, but we still cleared up a good amount. Not really though. From the looks of it, we only cleared up like two, like not really that much. We cleared up 3 million almost. So I think we'll enter a trade block. We'll sim a few more games and maybe call an episode. So we'll keep Nuge there, Lucic, and then who else should we throw up there? I don't know. There's no one really that. Maybe we'll throw up Koskinen. He doesn't have much value, but I'll throw him up just because he's. I mean, if anybody really wants him. But I think he's playing pretty well, so we'll simulate. We'll simulate. Let's see. Let's see. Let's see. We have gamers. We'll simulate to this game versus the Kings, and we don't get any trade offers. We'll call it an episode. Oh, just like that, we get 2020 second round pick for Nashville's. So we basically trading away Brandon Manning for an extra fourth round pick in this year's draft. Manning's playing in the fucking AHL, so I'm gonna take this because we're not really using Brandon Manning. We clear up 2.2 of cap, so man, Brandon Manning was playing the AHL. So let's go to lines, take that trade. Obviously, that gives, I think, it gives maybe Sammy Nikku a chance to move up as a top spot. Caleb Jones did, that's all good. And Nikku became ultimate captain, okay. So we're going on a tear right now. Two straight wins, two straight losses. But I'm surprised how well we're playing. St. Louis is garbage. So, and we get spanked by them. I'm not surprised. Tampa Bay, how are they playing? 20? Yeah, they're playing. They're just playing well in general. We lose, so we've been kind of on a losing streak here. Hopefully, we could turn it around. Gamers, Vancouver. Come on with these fucking injuries. Leave me alone. Damn, another loss just like that. Now we're going on a losing streak. Oh my goodness, can we win a game, please? Holy shit, we really lost a lot in a row. Wow, we are just terrible. This is a bad way to maybe end the episode, man. We just went on a what? We just went on. I'm gonna count the overtime. I'm gonna count the overtime. We just went on a 2, 4, 6. Hold on, I fucked up. 2, 4, 6. 8-9 game losing streak. I'm gonna just hopefully end the fucking. Can we fucking win it? Can we win this, please? I'm gonna. Sweet Jesus Christ. Terrible. We need to end on a W, but we're gonna go into this. Let's see what we got. First period, nothing. Second period. Are we really better? And we just lost to like probably one of the worst teams in the league. What is going on right now? We'll sim to the gamers, Calgary. But I don't know, we just totally fell off. I mean, was trading away. Yo. Yo. What the fuck? Was trading away Sakara really that big of a fucking problem? Finally, fucking win one. Jesus Christ. 19-17-6. We were just 18-6 and like 8. We lose again. Fuck, like, these fucking injuries really fucking are pissed. I'm literally about to turn them off. Like, there's no way someone gets injured every fucking game. Jesus Christ. I'm just doing best lines. Like, I don't even give a shit. Because it's a literally waste of fucking time. And now Ryan Nugent-Hopkins is out with back spasms. Alright, so a pretty terrible fucking stretch on our part. You know, we were having a good start of the season, but we find ourselves 48 points. The lowest in the league is St. Louis at 37. Oh, 31 from the Red Wings. So, we really have to... I don't even know. But, it's going to be it for this first episode, guys. So, hope you guys enjoy it. And hopefully we can turn around. And I'll maybe look at some players we can maybe pursue. And I'll see you guys in the next one.